is a canvas and painting in my mind. Colors dance, spill outside the lines. I refuse to settle, never the black and white. Rock the neons until the day I die. I'm on a constant search to make my heart swell.
Hi everybody, Deb's just cleaning up. We've just had something to eat, so it's prize giveaway time, and we're up to bag number four. Yes, I've hit record. Just being told. So in bag number four, I'll just go through everything with you. Hope you're having a good time. So first one is this lovely pink square bling, and it's from Jolie's. Then we've got the Petaloo lovely flowers. We've also got a lovely bag of lace from Deb's store. Sorry about the glare, ladies. And then we've got this fabulous stamp, Inspiration. We've got an oblong book, chipboard book, with the scalloped edge. Happy birthday embossing folder. Can you see? There we are. You can see. And we've got some of this lovely bling. We've got this stencil as well from Craft Decor, which is really very pretty. And last but not least, we have these little mini inchies. They're two little girls, tilting it down so you can see, and this beautiful angel. I'm not sure if you can see. Oh, sorry, going the wrong way. There we are. So that is bag number four, and the question is, how many design team members does Deb have?
On
Gone Artsy, not including her own. Herself. Told you the drink's got to my head. I've gone quiet, haven't I? That's because Deb's not here. My sidekick.
That's because I'm more exciting.
She is. I'm quite shy. Okay, that's everybody answered. And the lucky winner is... I'll do random.org, I think. Okay, ladies. Sophie's the winner from random.org. Congratulations, Sophie. Right. The next one is, next prize is Tim Holtz texture fades embossing folders, and we want you to guess a number between 50 and 100, please. I'll put some music on until you've all answered. No, it's not five catfish. We don't like catfish. You're cruel, Rhonda. You'll never go to heaven. Okay. Well, the answer that Deb wrote down, I'm not sure if you see it. Can you see?
Bring way up close like this. 52.
And the winner of that, who came close, is Deborah. Well done, Deborah. You've won the Tim Holtz folders, embossing folders. Now the boss is back and all peace will resume. I'm sorry.
Thank you for taking over, Linda, while I cleaned up from dinner. I can't stand having a messy kitchen, so.
Where's the pen?
I left it over there. Here you go.
Oops, thank you.
Okay, so. Shabby Patty did a project with our newest pieces in the shop, and so we're going to give away the first set. Whoops, pop dot's twisting. Of these beautiful clay pieces that are available in the store. This set will retail for $225. It's a large and a small, but we're going to give one away right now. Let's see, what game did I choose for this? Go to the store. Let me give you the link. Okay, so go to the store and tell me what is the 200th item in the store? Not by on the page, but the number 200 in the store. Come back and type in what that item is called. And in the meantime, we'll put the music on. Funny, you don't.
I love you.
Study nuclear science. I love my classes. I got a crazy teacher who wears dark glasses. Things are going great, and they're only getting better.
That was fun. So now that you've seen us act like fools, what's the answer? Anyway, before we go to Marianne, we'll come back to it. So you still have time to look. All right. Here we have a bag of lace. Several different laces from the Gone Artsy store. You have this beautiful heart pearl trim. Some of the cathedral lace, which is what Teresa used on her project. We have some teardrop dangle trim. We have, this is one of the newer laces. It's gorgeous. It's, yes, Pat, you won. Yes. Okay. Pat wins the clay faces. Pat Spencer. All right. Great job. Okay. So here's the other lace. It's this fun dragonfly. It's really pretty. Soft. It's really nice. Some of the bunting, flower bunting lace. The ever so popular butterfly dangle lace. This is like one of my top sellers. This is pink. It's hard to see in here, but it's a light pink color. The ivory three strand lace, and it's three different pieces, but they are tacked together so that it stays nicely when you work with it. Yep, I see that, Pat Spencer. Yay! And then the final piece of lace in this bag is the two-toned gold and white scalloped lace. All right, so for this one, where does Patty live? Where does Shabby Patty live? Okay, we got a Texas, we got a California, we got a Texas. How many more people we got to answer? Ooh, there's quite a few people here in my own little world.
I'm with you there, Patty.
UK, we got a UK. Okay, Kay Myers, you win the bag of lace. Shabby Patty lives in California. Okay, let's do a cup. Simple question. What is Deb's logo?
First, go.
Mickey got the cup. Okay, and the final prize, one more package. Quickly go through it because we're running a little behind. Like by 15 minutes, that's a lot actually. Okay, so we have the bling again. Another bag of lace. The Petaluke Color Me Crazy flowers. 2-inchy tile things. One is a girl, like just a pretty girl with a feathers and flowers in her hair. And the other one is an angel sitting in a tree or something. Anyway, that's it. A flower-shaped album. A happy birthday embossing folder. Creatopia. Cool dye. And rub-on transfers. Okay, for this question, what kind of coffee does Deb drink? What kind of coffee does Deb drink?
Yes, Mickey, it's empty. You're not getting any vodka.
I'll give you a hint. It's a trick question. Sleepy Inky got it right. Yay! Deb does not drink coffee. Deb drinks Rockstar for her caffeine.
Sleepy Inky.
Sleepy Inky is a friend of Mickey's. Well, I wrote it down. What was her name? Shoot. Where did I put it? No coffee. That's right. Sleepy Inky got it right. Okay, Sleepy Inky, if you could PM me on Facebook with your information, I will get that package, that prize package out to you. I'm going to sign off now, and we're going to hand it over to Marianne for her class. All right.
Okay, so once again, the wooden chandelier from Prima, I did a coat of gesso. Once I did once it was dry, I did a coat of a crackling paint. I did a coat of pink poodle craft paint. And when it was all dry, I used the gelatos. I used the chocolate one, and I used the hi Jenny. It's nice to see you around. I used a little bit of black, and then how I used my gelatos, you can use your craft mat, but today I've been using this plate as my palette. So I just, you know, like scribbled the gelato in the paper, and then take a little sponge. You can use a brush, you know, and get it a little wet, you know, rub it in here, and then I went over it. You cannot see the crackles a whole lot because I stamped over it as well. So I went over with the sponge and I just rub it in so it went into the crackles and some of the crackles and all the way around. And I like mix a little bit of the brown, a little bit of the black. When that was all done and dry, I took some archival ink, and you can use any permanent ink, and I was looking for a stamp that has some, you know, my stash that has some scribble or some. So what I did was, like, I stamp, you know, randomly. There's no rhyme or reason. I just stamp all over just to give it that, you know, messy old look. And I was contemplating cover the piece with paper, but it has so many little details. It has so many little details that will be kind of hard to, you know, like glue and, you know, file around, and I don't know. So that's why I decided to do a little bit of a texture, a little bit of like a mixed media style. And then what I did was I add some medium, and I found I still have some of this from the store. Is that glass glitter, and it's the gold fusion chunk. And this one has gone, I mean, I've used it so many times. This little bottle goes so long. It goes a long way. So I'm telling you, all you need is a little bit. So I cover what it should be, the lights. And I was hesitant of doing gold because some of the accessories that I'm going to be using are gonna be silver. But I guess, you know, if it's a metal color, to me metal, it's, you know, neutral. So I'm gonna do a combination of silver and gold. So, well, this is what I have so far. I am going to using some of the flowers from Gone Artsy, as well as some of the trends. And yeah, once again, like I've always said on my videos, I start with an idea, and then as I go, then, you know, things start shaping differently. I'm trying a different angle on my camera because, you know, once this is put together, we're gonna assemble this together. Once it's assembled together, there's no way that you're gonna be able to see it if I, you know, have my camera above. So, okay, so I think I'm done prepping the base. So I'm gonna try to assemble the piece. And this is a very delicate piece. I hope I don't break it. All right, there you go. This is such a pretty piece. It's beautiful. And it's big. I thought it was going to be smaller. It's a big piece. Great for decoration in a scrap room, or I'm planning on having it here on my corner. I don't know how I'm gonna hang it yet, but I'm sure gonna try to. So I need to push a little bit further. So this is how it assembles together. And I have an assistant today. Camila is here, and she said she was gonna help me. So are your hands clean? Go and clean your hands and then you come back. She was playing outside, so. All right, so I'm gonna put this to the side, and I'm gonna start working with my embellishments. So I put it somewhere there. So I'm gonna cover it. So, as part of the embellishments for the chandelier, is this pack. Whoop, is this pack of beautiful glasses. Say hi.
Hi.
All right. Okay, so she's gonna be my assistant, okay? So, we have different choices of dangles. We have these pretty ones, and then we have ones that are more like teardrops.
I'll cry in silver.
Okay, and then it also has this beautiful chain. This is so cool. I love it. So you see, like I was saying, like all these little things are like in silver, but I wanted my lights to be gold. So, all right. So also, I'm gonna move this to the side. And I'm going to be using some beautiful flowers.
Flowers? These flowers?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, the bag with this, that's part of the chandelier. So I'm going to be using this flowers.
How about this?
It's from Prima.
Mommy, how about this?
Yes, those two. And I'm gonna be using some of these ones, and
those,
some of these ones, and let's see what else, because, you know, as I go, I start pulling. Oh, another thing that I wanted to use is this beautiful trim. So Deb just showed it in one of the bags for the games. The price is that three different trims in one, but they're like entwined. So it stayed together. So I'm planning on using some of this too.
All right.
So let's see how it goes.
Shoot like hell, have my nights spent in a hotel. Price I pay to escape the conveyor belt. One, you get one heartbeat song.
Okay, let me put this one up a little bit so you see what I just did. I add the stem right here.
It's good.
And then I'm going to add another one in the opposite side.
Good.
Take it seriously. This is your masterpiece. Don't forget to dream and taste the colors.
So I have the two vines on the opposite sides. Like I said, these ones you can move and you can, you know, adjust and make them go wherever you want. All right, so these ones are just like paper flowers.
Paper flowers are the best. They're really cute.
Yeah, good thing is about these flowers is that you can combine them.
They're really cute. They have different colors.
They have purple, that's Camila's favorite color.
And also pink.
And that's my favorite color.
Tomorrow's like a favorite.
Okay, so let's do this.
Blue.
I'm gonna start building up.
Blue.
So I'm gonna put some of these flowers together. So how is everybody doing? Have you guys missed our Tuesday classes? I miss
so much hanging out with you guys on Tuesdays. You know, it was a nice break to just get to sit and chat with ladies that are talented and that we all share the same passion for crafting and creating. Yeah, I know you're gonna hear a whole lot of mess kind of in the background, you know, there's soccer going on, my husband is watching it. And
okay,
so I'm gonna keep going. I'm just adding, putting some flowers together. I try to be a matchy-matchy, so I'm trying to make them all look the same. But you don't have to. I mean, so I try to, make the match. And I have a wonderful craft sisterhood. my crafting sisters are amazing. And they are very supportive. And here I am when I could not just say, I'm not gonna be part of the anniversary. I was part of it last year, not as a design member, but as a, fan. I was just watching the whole show. I even won some prizes and it was so much fun. So I had to be here today. I think you guys not seeing what I'm doing here. Let me just put the camera a little bit lower. But what I've done so far is I'm just gluing all these flowers together, building them up. So yes, Camila.
Can I put them inside?
Yes, put them in here so I can start using it.
Okay.
So you see, all I've done is like just build a whole bunch of little flowers. I put them together like as I think fits, and Yeah, pretty much it. And now I'm gonna add to these big ones, I'm gonna add some of the little ones to give it some more dimension. Okay. Yes, Camila.
Can you show the flowers?
Yeah, go ahead and show the flowers. She wants to show the flowers. They can't, okay, those are the tiny ones and they're super cute because they have a little bead in the center and it's gonna match with the gold that I add for the bulbs. Yeah, I agree. It's never too much pink. But if you follow me, if you see my channel, if you see you know, any of my creations, I usually stick with very pale colors. Like almost all my stuff is like whites and creams, very clean, very neutral. And I, my resolution for this year, even though I have not been crafting a whole lot, when this year started, my resolution was to, it was to try and use more colors. Purple. Okay, Camila, I think they see them all.
Well, I forgot to see a purple one.
Okay, show them the purple one. Okay, purple. I'm gonna show her, them what I'm doing. You see, so now what I do, it's,
big.
I have some of the big ones and the small one. I just build up, you know.
Big, medium, small. Don't stop till it is beautiful.
Don't stop till it is beautiful. So I'm going to start adding them. Let's see how you can see here. I want to start adding them like right here. I want some, the bigger ones in the outside, and then I'm going to fill up in the inside with some more of the small ones. So I'm going to start in the sides that I don't have the vine. Don't stop till it is beautiful. You know, it's never enough pink. It's never too much pink. It's never too much glitter. That's what I said. So, who agrees with me? Close my eyelids, take a deep breath, feel the lightning down in my chest. Okay, so I'm adding the larger flowers to the bottom of the of what it's holding the candle or the light. So I have the outside, you know, flowers already done, so I'm gonna use the rest of them to put randomly inside. I have the vine in this side and this one doesn't have anything, so I'm gonna put some in this side. And the paint's fresh, cause I'm not near finished yet. I got a pregnant mind, no one's to give birth. Breathe life into these big words. I can hear the universe in my ear. She whispers, one, you get one heartbeat song. So I have this, and I still have a bunch of the small flowers, of the tiny ones. I still have a bunch of these ones, but I would like to add the trim and the chains first. Huh? Can you tell Daddy, please?
Okay. Wrong
one. So I'm going to see, because I would like to hang this one like from here to here. Okay, so I want to do, yeah, I should have done this one before the flowers because I just changed my mind. Like I said, you know, you start working and you know, you're like Patty said earlier, you start working and then your head goes, you know, different places and you start changing your mind and you start doing different things. So I was planning first on putting them from the top down to where the light is, but what I'll do is that I'm gonna put it down here and okay, let's do it this way. Take it seriously. This is your masterpiece. Don't forget. of course, never too much lace or pearls. Okay, we have the whole package in there, right? Never enough. Yes, I always said, if you have a better choice of adhesive, go for it, because I mean, I use the hot glue gun on this project because I want it to dry instantly. We don't have the benefit of, you know, wait for things to dry since it's a live class. I want to use the long ones in the outside, this long one. And I'm gonna get my handy pliers, and these ones are jump rings, so this is gonna be interesting. All right, so we're gonna have this one right here, and I'm gonna open this a little bit more because it's kind of I just have a few more minutes left, so what I'm gonna do is, like, I'm gonna finish one side and show it to you, and I will be posting pictures of the finish chandelier on the side, on the Gonartsy, on the Facebook, the Gonartsy fan Facebook fan page. I'm sorry. And okay, I got this one. Okay, it's gonna give an idea of how this one is gonna look. So this is the long one, and then what I would like to do is have the teardrop one in the center, and then another one of the tall ones in the bottom. That is the plan. Then I will also like to use the chain from the top to the side. Well, this one you can actually, yeah, you can use it for hang it, or I really, really want to use it to put it some from the top, you know, going down here. And then I will use some of the lace to make a holder for the top. And then once that's done, what I'll do is, like, I add the rest of the little flowers. I will add them around to make it more full. And like I said, I'm already, it's 8:44. But what I'll do is I'll get it finished, and then I will post some pictures on the Facebook group, as well as in my Facebook page. And then yeah, this is it. So I want to thank you, everybody, for being here tonight. I want to say once again, happy anniversary, Miss Deb. 2 years of great products. And everybody, please stop at the store and take a look. It's like every time you go in, it's a whole different store, because it's so, so many new products. And what else for me to say? Thank you for all the support to my crafty sisters. And I miss you all. I really, really miss those Tuesdays. And this is it. I thank you much for watching. Like I said, I'm gonna now finish adding all the dangles, and I might just change this a little bit, you know how it goes. So what I'll do is, like, I post the pictures, and I'll let you guys see it. So thank you very much for hanging out with me today. So I'm going to log off, and we'll be back to dance. So have a great night, and I'll see you all soon. Bye bye.